Dear friends, let us try to exterior angle property. This is what we have already decided to study. Now, consider triangle ABC. ABC and angle ACD is an exterior angle. So, consider triangle ABC with ACD as an exterior angle and angle ACD is an exterior angle, Now, in order to prove the exterior angle property, exterior angle property we have already studied, we know that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. So, we have to prove that angle ACD is equal to angle ABC plus angle BAC. This is what we need to prove. Now, for this, we are going to draw CE parallel to BA. So, draw CE parallel to BA. Now, if you draw CE parallel to C, this is CE parallel to BA. Now, in order to prove this, let us consider this CE parallel to BA and AC as a transversal. So, consider BA parallel to CE and AC as transversal. So, if you consider AC as transversal, you will get this angle equal to this angle. They are alternate interior angles formed by parallel lines and a transversal are equal. That is what we have studied in our earlier chapter. It means angle BAC is equal to angle ACE. Reason is alternate angle property. That is what we have already studied. Now, if you consider BA parallel to CE and this time consider BC as a transversal. If you consider BC as a transversal, then you will get these two angles as corresponding angles. It means angle ABC equals to angle ECD. Reason is they are corresponding angle property. Now, adding equations 1 and 2, you will get, let us see what we get, angle BAC plus angle ABC is equal to angle ACE plus angle ECD. Watch carefully, this is equal to this, if you add, equality remains equality. So, look at the figure now, ACE plus ECD, this side, right hand side. ACE plus ECD, they can be added because they are adjacent angles. ACE plus ECD is equal to angle ACD. So you will get LHS will remain as it is. Angle BAC plus angle ABC equals to angle ACD. And by this we understand ACD is an exterior angle and it is equal to BAC means this. And ABC means this. So, it means exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Thus, we can say that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Dear friends, let us try to understand exterior angle. We have already studied exterior angle means angle that forms a linear pair with the interior angle. So, and this is an exterior angle. In this figure A, B, C, D, angle ACD is an exterior angle. You can see exterior angle can be drawn in other way also. This, if you extend the side, this also forms a linear pair. So, exterior angle can be formed in this way as well. So, angle E is an exterior angle. This is also an exterior angle. Now, thus watch carefully at vertex C. At vertex C, we have got two exterior angles. Please note, if this figure is combined, then you will notice that we are getting two exterior angles. Two exterior angles at vertex C. One is ACD, other is BCE. Please note, they are vertically opposite angles. They are vertically opposite angles. So, at a vertex, two angles we get and both the angles are equal to each other. Now, at vertex A also, we will get two exterior angles. Watch carefully. A, B, C. So, here, this angle P forms a linear pair with the interior angle A, and this angle also forms a linear pair with the interior angle. So these two are exterior angles and both exterior angles are equal to one another. Both are equal to each other. Reason is they are vertically opposite angles. Please note, exterior angle always forms a linear pair with the interior angle. So sum of exterior angle and interior angle, adjacent interior angle, is always 180 degrees. Thus, sum of exterior angle and adjacent interior angle is always supplementary. Supplementary means 180 degrees. Is always supplementary, that is 180 degrees. And at vertex B also, we will get two exterior angles. One is this side, the other is this side. So every triangle has six exterior angles.